Hi everybody, I'm here with my two buddies, Pepper and Andy, and we had a video we put out yesterday that showed some items that we picked up. I needed to make some more toys. I wanted to show people how inexpensive this can be and how much fun it can be to go out and find items at thrift stores, dollar stores, Fred's. Even if you don't have that in your area, it might be a flea market where they bundle a lot of these hard toys. What are you doing, buddy? Some of these hard toys and items you can use for toys. Now, we did the video yesterday showing those items before we made the toys, and it was $26.50. I put it here on the paper so you can see it. Now, we only had enough chain to do like 12 or 13 toys, so I added another $14 is what it would cost to buy more chain, and that gets us to $40.50, which brings us to $1.56 for each toy. And on the table here, I've got a row of toys up at the top that we made. We drilled them all. It only took a couple hours. Lots of fun. The whole family can get involved, or you can do it by yourself. Doesn't matter if you have one bird or if you have 50 birds. It's a great way to do it. I'm going to show you a couple of them we made. This one I called a giraffe and made it nice and long. Pretty cool looking. This one we call the elephant. That's got an elephant head on it.
Dan, you're having too much fun with this.
And lastly, the puppy dog. So, pretty cool items. There's 13 here. I laid out these as if they were toys, and I put 10 items in each row since we didn't have the chain to show 13 more that we would build. And then I do have extra, and this is some extra stuff. And generally, I do like to use wood and put wood in it. And that you can go in your backyard and you can cut some safe trees. There's a list you can get online of trees that you can use and cut them up and put them in here because I like them to chew on stuff. I love the rawhide because they can grab it and pull on it. If you remember, we had a whole stack of these that came with these little balls and they attached here. These were straight. I heated them in the oven at 200 degrees on a pan with foil, or you can put any item that's so it won't stick, and let them heat up, get warm, and go ahead, pull it out. You can make a knot like this and then put them back in, because when you take them out, this is very hard plastic, and I would only use very hard plastic. If it's soft or whatever, don't use it. It's just going to be too dangerous. Then put it back in, let it get soft again, and then bend it some more, and you'll end up with stuff like this. Very hard. And it works really good. You can see I put it on a lot of the toys because I thought it'd be fun and interesting for them to grab them. Also, you don't have to string them real tight. That way they can move them. And then we always put a nice item on the bottom. We saw these yesterday. And we just put that on the bottom. So just really, really fun stuff. And I guess if I were to say anything, you want to hop down here, buddy? Come here. Let's go look at these toys. Let's check them out. If I were to say anything, just enjoy the journey. And this is one way to do that. We can really have a lot of fun. We can save a lot of money. Let me quickly explain to you. I wrote down here, if we had these items and even added another $10 to this whole deal for extra clips or whatever you need, we would be up to $50.50. That's $1.94 per toy. That's less than $2 per toy. And if we were to buy them online or buy them at a store, we would pay $10, probably minimum, especially if you had shipping. So we save $200 if we paid $10. If we paid $15, we save $339.50 by building them ourselves. And I think they're pretty cool. I think they're bright. They're fun. These guys are going to have a blast. Thanks for watching.